was a known name.
Our older people couldn't say who they was. No way. Because they did, they'd get spat on, whatever.
We kept quiet about the background.
We had to.
Still do.
We had to, yeah.
They're still prejudiced now, yeah.
The name itself, you see.
Even now, if I want particular jobs, yes, they say to me, have you got a skeleton in your cupboard?
Right.
And I said I was a gypsy, I wouldn't get a job.
Well, to be honest with you, right, I've never had that problem.
The other week, just joking, he said, why don't you say you don't a gypsy? Open, John. I said, because anything that's stolen in this pub, it comes straight to me. Yes!
Oh, I know that.
The teacher said, do you know Loveridge? I said, yeah, we do. He said, well, he's a gypsy. And you don't have no need to be afraid of
him. Well, this is... I'm sorry, Don, but I've got to put in there. They said, are you afraid of gypsies? Stand up, Loveridge. He's a gypsy. Are you afraid of Loveridge? Well, that's what brings it down.
All our older brothers, which was a lot, obviously, used to be in the boys, Boy Scouts and...
Boys Brigade.
But when we was kids, we couldn't join it because they wouldn't take the uniforms back. So we couldn't join the Boys Brigade. So we was persecuted once again. When we was... you were Loveridge, you got no chance. No, your brother wouldn't bring the uniforms back. So we was persecuted again.
There were many things which the gypsies used to sell to make a living. And coast pigs was one of them.
I've got one, but it's done by a modern gypsy, and it's not the same as my mother used to.
Oh, yeah, well.
So I won't show you.
And that was made out of hazel wood. And this would be sort of a can.
An old tin can.
So sardine can. It had to be Springer.
When the last gypsy left these grounds, she was named Ente, and she was the queen of Esau Smith, and he'd ended up in Parrot Street, Esau did. When she died, she was about 90 when she died. When the council moved the gypsies off this ground here, and to make a public park, as we know it today, they took, Ente was left there because she was old and she until she died. And then her caravan was taken to Watson Pool, like I'd said, and it was burned on the side of Watson Pool, and anything not valuable, not jewellery, crockery and that were thrown into that pool. And in those days it was when we were kids it was a cholera, Amsi cholera.
It was the most persecuted nation on earth.
Three of us went to Fernley Road School. I went to Handsworth New Road School because I'm a bit older than these guys.
I think when we was kids, there was Winston Green and Handsworth, which is a big difference. I don't think there was it wasn't all in one.
Well, no, we walked through Handsworth mainly to get to the countryside, which was beyond this. And I say, when we went, the telephones would be ringing, saying there's people actually coming through. All the houses there would be big families, servants. Handsworth was the area to live in. It was absolutely magnificent. If we walked the streets of Handsworth, they would sell. Just as soon as you did, they'd phone the police and want to know why you did.
Handsworth was posh to us. The park was fantastic.
That was beautiful, like it is today. It was
11 to Rookie Road, then we used to get the bus down Rookie Road and get the
bus. We used to have an allotment at the Uplands. Where it is still today, our allotment is still there today.
Handsworth Park on a summer's afternoon used to be packed.
If you lived in Handsworth, you were somebody, you know.